Who's daddy's boy? Say dun dun.
Hey, do you know what your schedule's like on Friday?
Next Friday? I don't know.
Cause see, I got a dentist appointment and I don't think Kim's gonna be available. Hello, Don.
Oh, I'm sorry. What'd you say?
Are you listening to me?
Yeah.
Can you help me get this?
Honey, you know I can never get it.
Well, could you try, please?
Tomorrow, I promise I'm gonna get it fixed.
Yeah, that's what you always say, but it's still broken.
Excuse me. Excuse me. Is everything okay?
What? I didn't know what you said.
I said, is everything okay?
Everything's fine.
Because you keep staring at me and my wife.
Okay, I ain't looking at nothing.
Donovan,
I
mean, just
you got
come
something on.
On
your mind.
Listen to your wife.
All right, keep looking. Keep looking. Okay? Hey, don't worry about him. He's
stop
fine.
It. What are you doing? Have you lost your mind?
Hey, Jada, don't go all nigger on my ass.
They'd laugh at the truth. I'd end up with my head in the noose.
Why did you have to do it, Jimmy? Why?
What else was I going to do but hide the body and get away from the car there with him in it? Not my style.
Stubbs, what's
hey,
up, man?
Roy, what's up? Listen, I need a place to crash.
Don't you love your auntie? Beautiful boy, look at the world. Let's say hello to your Uncle Jonah.
Uncle Jonah, hello.
Uncle Jonah, hello.
Hi.
Where'd you get that beer?
In the fridge. Can you believe we're related to these people?
Well, I married into this family. You had the fortune to be born into it.
Lucky me.
So how are you, Tiffany?
Good, I guess.
You guess?
I've been going to the gym a lot.
I can tell. You look good.
Thanks. I mean, there's nothing else to do around here. There's no work in Richmond at all. It sucks.
I know how you feel. What?
You know what it feels like to be an unemployed 21-year-old girl?
Well, no, but I have many who work for me.
Really? Doing what? My mom told me you own, like, a club or something?
Yeah, a gentleman's club.
You mean, like, a strip club? I almost did that, but I don't have the body for
well,
it.
Well, it's not a strip club, really. I run a business where women are paid to provide certain services, certain pleasures for men.
Hookers? Gross.
Gross?
It's demeaning.
Hey, Tiffany, you have a clean toilets at the Richmond Stadium? Now that's demeaning.
Do you really run a whorehouse?
Look, I never should have brought it up. If it's not your thing, it's not your thing.
I'm not a prude or nothing. I just have self-respect.
Right, right.
Well, and it's not safe or legal.
Hey, my employees have never gotten arrested and have never gotten so much as a cold. The only thing they've gotten is rich.
Oh, there you are. Come on. Mommy wants us to have a picture.
Let me
the
just
baby.
Finish the beer.
All right. Hurry up. And you know what? My sweet cousin Tiffany needs a job. Jonah knows everybody.
Thank you, Janet.
You're welcome, honey.
Rich.
Yeah. What was that address again?
Look right at the camera when I tell you. I'll talk to Hannah. Then I kill you. Just wait for me right here.
Okay. Hello? My name is Lisa Cohen. I'm the special agent in charge of the FBI office here in Richmond. We're asking your help today in finding Hannah Tyler Sorensen. We believe that Hannah was abducted. Hannah is 9 years old. She has blonde hair, blue eyes. When she was dressed for school this morning, she was wearing blue jeans and a purple sweatshirt. Hannah is a fourth grader at Hamilton Elementary. That's all I have for you now, but I'd like to introduce to you Kelly Sorensen, Hannah's mother.
Hey, sorry about your day off.
No problem. What happened?
Mom goes for coffee around 7, comes back to find her only child missing along with her favorite pink backpack.
She leave early for school?
No, school's 2 miles away. Mom drives her every day. Nobody's seen the kid all morning.
Kick, pull, scream. Remember, you're a survivor.
Possible runaway? Mom says she was happy. No fights.
Her lunchbox was still on the kitchen counter.
And that's the mother, right?
Yeah, Kelly Sorensen, stay-at-home mom.
And where's the dad?
Died 9/11. Tower 1.
Van Doren.
Hey, boss, nice job.
Thanks. Listen, I want you to go inside, hold her hand, let her know that we're doing everything we can. I need to be focused on finding her.
Ma'am.
I'm not done. She's no good to us if she's incoherent. Understood?
Mm-hmm. But should somebody with a little more experience be handled?
You're not up for this?
I'm fine. I'm okay. Wherever you need me.
In the house. Check in on the hour.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Let's go. I'm dying for a cigarette.
You know Van Doren lost her husband in 9/11 at the Pentagon, right?
Yes, I know that.
Hey, can you clear the room? Just give us some privacy.
Sure, no problem.
Thanks. Hi, Kelly. My name's Paige Van Doren, and I'm an agent with the FBI, and I'm gonna be with you through this.
Thank you.
We are going to find your daughter.
Sleep all right?
Like a log. You know, with the baby, I wake up every couple hours.
Uh-huh.
How about you? Sleep well? Sorry, man. Jada, she's used to it.
Why?
You got anything to eat?
Mm. Hot dog buns, soy sauce, and ketchup. It's the last orange juice, sorry.
How about water? Any water?
Might have to wash a glass.
Great.
Let me ask you something, Stubbs.
What's up?
What are you doing here?
Yeah. Not really in the mood to get into it right now, Roy.
No, I don't mean that. I mean, what are you doing here?
Because I trust you. Are you okay with me being here, right?
Yeah, no, it's cool. Did
you look at this, Roy? This makes me mad as hell.
I'm not gonna take it anymore.
This is bullshit.
Hannah Sorensen was 7 years old when her father was killed on September 11, 2001. And now, the unthinkable has happened. How much tragedy can one woman bear? The Sorensens moved back to Richmond.
Jesse, you all set here?
The family decided it was time for...
Wait, guys, listen up, please. After the loss of a father... Thanks for all being here on such short notice, especially those of you who had a day off. We are getting Hannah Sorensen back today. No one comes into our town and steals our children. Nobody. Okay. Right. Where's Stevens?
He should be in the tech room with the guys.
Stevens, you got all our bases covered?
Yeah, we're checking all registered sex offenders.
All right, what about Hannah's home computer?
Tech's downloading her chat history as we speak.
All right, so Mom leaves at 7, she's back at 7:45. It's not much of a window.
Someone was sitting on the house, saw the mother leave.
I knew she'd be going. Would she go for coffee?
Yeah.
Credit card receipt puts the mom at the coffee shop at 7:20. Staff says she's there every morning.
Every morning?
Yeah, Monday through Friday.
Well, she leaves her kid alone every morning to go get coffee? Does anybody else think that's odd?
She's a single parent. Maybe she needs a little jolt to get her through the morning. Hannah's not an infant. She's 9 years old.
No, but still, it's some morning routine.
So what are you thinking?
I'm thinking, what kind of mother are we dealing with?
So, how many kidnapping cases have you been on?
It's my... Van Doren. Great. Send her through. Thank you. Your mother's here. It's my first, but our rapid start team is first rate, Kelly, okay?
Mama. I got here as fast as I could.
Oh, God, I should never have left her alone.
Oh, you just went for coffee.
I just need to see adults in the morning. I know you don't approve.
Is James here?
No.
Who's James? Paige Van Doren, FBI.
Oh, Amy Frost.
Nice to meet you. James who?
James Lawson.
It's her boyfriend.
Ex-boyfriend.
When did that happen?
Last night.
Okay.
I thought the two...
Excuse me, ladies. I need you to tell me exactly what happened last night.
Kelly and I dated for 3 months.
Right.
She came in here looking for study guides in chemistry. She wants to be a nurse. Well, that's what she says anyway.
What? You don't think that's true anymore?
Well, Kelly says a lot of things.
You think Kelly's a good mother to Hannah?
I think Kelly's mother is a good mother to Hannah.
What do you mean by that?
I didn't even know Kelly had a kid until 3 weeks ago.
How is that possible? I don't understand.
Well, we always went back to my place, and never hers. It was getting kind of ridiculous, and then finally she told me. Hannah was pretty much everywhere we were after that. It made things really different, you know. Well, it made Kelly even more...
More?
Yeah. I have no idea what it's like to have your husband, the father of your child, die right in front of you on television. Or what it's like to know that every time you turn on the TV, you might have to see that again. But it happened 2 years ago, and that's all she ever talks about. And Kelly's needy. She's way too needy for me.
And you told her all this last night?
No, I told her a week ago. Last night was her idea. She wanted me to reconsider.
And?
Nothing had changed.
Hey, can I rent something?
Yeah.
Okay, James Lawson. He was at the gym at 6:30, and he went straight to work. I don't think he knows anything about what happened to Hannah.
Come on. They break up for the second time last night, and she disappears today.
I don't think that was anything more than bad timing on his part. Look, Kelly is a mess emotionally. You want my opinion?
Yeah.
She's not comfortable being a mother, Lisa. She's not even comfortable being his girlfriend.
What do you mean?
Okay, according to James, Kelly's all about being a widow. Right? It's her identity now. James comes along, suddenly she's a girlfriend. She's not a widow anymore. You know what I think? I think she needs to be the victim.
So Hannah disappears and it's poor Kelly all over again.
Yeah, exactly. That's what she wants.
James go to the house last night?
No, they went out.
Where was Hannah?
What time did Kelly come pick her up? Mina?
11:30.
Well, that's kind of late for a school night.
She'd had a lot to drink. A lot. I made her come in. James was the first guy since Scott she'd really fallen for. let herself fall for since Scott died.
So why do you think it didn't work out with James?
Kelly had trouble balancing everything, making it all work. Dating would be a hell of a lot easier if you didn't have kids.
Did Kelly say that last night?
Every single mom has said that. Doesn't mean we love our kids any less.
All right, so Kelly leaves Mina's house at approximately 1 a.m. with Hannah, and no one sees Hannah again.
Kelly could have killed her anytime before 7:20 a.m. when she was seen at the coffee shop. She could have. Her boyfriend dumps her. She gets roaring drunk. She decides she's tired of being a single mom, and hey, you know, she misses the attention she got 2 years ago.
You saw her this morning. Those tears were real.
She is a bit whack as a mother.
Okay, so she's no mom of the year, but that doesn't make her a child mother.
There was something off about her this morning.
She was hungover. What?
No, it's more than that. Look, I think she knows exactly what happened to Hannah.
No scars?
No.
Couple of tattoos, though. That's okay, guys find that sexy. Hold your arms out to your side and separate your legs. Any piercings that aren't studded?
No.
Okay, now for the rules. You follow the... I'm sorry, you can get dressed.
Okay.
You follow the rules and everyone goes home happy. Rule number one, always use a condom.
It's okay, I'm on the pill.
No, it doesn't matter. You always use a condom. It's the same thing for oral sex. Always use a condom. It keeps you from disease, which is why there's no kissing on the mouth, because of disease.
Okay.
And also kissing... Are you listening to me?
Yeah.
Kissing is too intimate, and that's bad for business. So no kissing. You pull away, you do whatever you gotta do. Okay, prices. It's $125 for an hour, $85 for a half hour. My advice, get them to book you for an hour. And you can talk to Bambi and some of the other girls, and they can tell you how to do this. But you get them to book you for an hour because they won't take that long. But you still get paid for the full hour. Any tips on top of the set fee are yours to keep. But don't let me hear that a tip is holding up service.
What happens mostly?
Well, it's mostly 50-50. That's half oral, half sex. You okay with that?
Sure. What happens if they want to do something else, something that I don't want to do?
Well, you try to make them happy, but be safe, be smart, don't get hurt, and that also includes your feelings.
Got it.
Okay. Well, everyone has the same first customer, so you ready for this?
Yeah.
Okay, wait here.
Okay.
You wanna go outside, do something?
No, thanks. This tubs.
Come on, man. Talk to me. Doctor's in. Did you and Jada have a fight or something?
She's pissed at me because I took a swing at some guy.
You hit a guy?
Yeah, I did. He was staring at me and Jada, a guy really behind the times.
Did he say something about you and Jada being a mixed couple?
But he was thinking it.
I can tell.
Believe me, you can tell. When you're a white man married to a black woman, people stare. And I can only swallow so much of it, so I went over to straighten the guy out, and Jada got all upset and sided with him. And I said to look at, don't go all nigger on my ass, and here we are.
You said that to her?
Yeah.
You called her nigger.
Yeah, but I didn't mean it. It's just a word, man.
Nigger is the word of no return, Stubbs.
Yeah, well, you know what? Screw her. She knows I didn't mean anything by it.
Come in.
Hello, Tiffany.
Hey.
So, what do you think?
Everybody seems really nice.
You know, Tiffany, if you don't want to, you don't have to do this.
It's all good, Jonah.
Because it's not for everyone.
I'm okay.
I guess I stopped taking pictures after 9/11.
Okay, well, what about her last birthday?
Well, I sent you those duplicates.
I know. I don't know where they are. I need to put these in an album. How many pictures do you need?
It's okay. We want different images out there just in case her hair has been cut or dyed. We want people to have as much information about her as possible, okay? Does she take any medicine? Does she have any allergies?
No.
Yes, actually, to bee stings. Do you remember, honey, a few months ago we were at the zoo and she needs to have an
epidemic. I need to get something to drink.
Why don't you get me a glass
sure.
of iced tea? Would you mind lemon
I
sugar? You know, she does the best she can with Hannah.
She's a beautiful little girl.
My daughter's not the same person she was on September 10th.
None of us are.
It's just that it was so hard on her when Scott died. I don't know. And he wasn't even the man I would have picked for her. But it's not my choice, is it? You don't get to deal the cards in this life. You just get to play them.
I told you a second.
Oh, yeah.
This is Special Agent Tremont.
Please apologize. We need to see
no.
this. No. Mrs. Sorensen, we have no new information. I'm Special Agent Sampson.
Here.
Now, when we have a missing child, we have to employ every investigative tool that we have available. One of those tools is a polygraph.
It's a lie detector.
Yes, ma'am. We found it beneficial to polygraph parents.
You want me to take a lie detector test?
It's protocol.
You think that I did this?
It's routine.
Listen to the woman. She's just doing her job.
Kelly, it's just protocol.
The test is about to begin. Were you born in August?
Yes.
Is your child's name Hannah?
Hannah Sorensen.
Kelly, just like we reviewed, you have to answer yes or no. Regarding the disappearance of Hannah, do you intend to be completely truthful?
Yes.
Do you know where Hannah is right now?
No.
Miss Sampson, it's right there.
I know, but I still say there's something off about Kelly. She's young.
Everybody listen up, please. Polygraph test is in and Kelly Sorensen passed. While this doesn't rule her out entirely as a suspect, we are moving on. I want you to concentrate on your other leads. That's it.
Kelly, I need you to be fully together for when Hannah comes home, okay?
Hannah's dead. I feel it. They told me Scott was still alive. They found a man who was burned over 90% of his body. But he had green eyes. Scott had green eyes. I need to leave this house every morning because part of me still believes that he's gonna come walking up the front lawn. I'm out of false hope. You married?
My husband was in the Pentagon on September 11th. He was killed.
You didn't tell me.
Your child's missing, that's what's important. And Kelly, I still believe that she's alive.
Do you have kids?
We wanted to someday.
Scott and I got married right out of school. We had Hannah exactly 9 months later. We fought because he worked all the time. Never really got to be young. How about you guys?
Jake and I fought about the laundry. Sounds stupid, I know, but it used to make me so mad because he would not check his pockets. It's the last conversation we had. We got in a fight about the laundry. That's how I said goodbye to him.
Call me back on that, all right?
Hey, boss, you got something?
Maybe. Okay, everybody, listen up. This may be something. There was an international flight to Montreal out of Reagan National that left at 11:45 a.m. A man and little girl checked in but didn't board. Their names were Mark Riggs and Tyler Riggs. That's it.
Tyler. Tyler's Hannah's middle name.
This is it.
Boss, Tyler's Hannah's middle name. We got it.
Jada? Jada? I got a 1 o'clock reservation. Let's go. Come on. Tiffany?
Janet.
What are you doing?
Making some money. I know it's not the best job.
No, not the best job.
You're gonna be cool with this, right? I mean, you're not gonna tell my mom or anything. I've gotta get back.
Okay, everybody, listen up. This just came in from airport police at Reagan National. Eyewitnesses saw a man in a Patriots baseball cap approach airport security. With him was a little girl, purple sweatshirt, blue jeans, pink backpack, long blonde hair. She appeared to be unharmed. The man stopped at security, took the little girl's hand, turned around, and left the airport. That's it. Let's get on it.
Lisa, so she took his hand, so she knows
Lisa,
him, right?
Check me in last. We got it. Database sent it over. Driver's license of Mark Riggs. No prior arrests, no registered guns.
Get it to Kelly, see if she recognizes him. That's our guy.
Nice work, Stevens. We'll keep you around a little longer.
It's coming through. Kelly, does this man look familiar to you?
My husband.
It's Scott.
One of its cell phone records.
Text on it. George promised me he'd have something within that.
Mark Riggs wanted a red Geo Metro. We've got the plates.
Good. Border Patrol's been alerted.
I put the order up, but I'll check.
Nice work.
So he's headed back to Canada.
It's a good bet. Wild, huh?
Yeah, at least the girl's okay, right?
For now.
Yeah. Is he prone to violence?
No.
Have you, you ever seen him lose his temper?
No.
Can I have to ask you this? Have you seen him in the past 2 years?
No.
You haven't had any contact?
No.
He moved in October 2001. He tried to start a computer business.
Miss Cohen, I bring gifts.
What do you got?
Riggs' cell number.
You're kidding me. Send in Samson and Stevens right away, would you?
Samson, Steven?
Scott Sorensen's cell phone.
Really?
Yeah.
Hello?
Scott?
Yeah?
Scott Sorensen?
Yes.
I need you to listen to me very carefully. My name is Lisa Cohen of the FBI.
We need to triangulate the call.
Is Hannah okay?
Of course she is. Look, I'm a real sorry about this mess, Agent.
I need to speak with Hannah. Put her on the phone, please.
Right, sorry. Here, honey, she wants to speak to you.
Hello?
Hi, Hannah. My name is Lisa. Is your daddy taking good care of you?
Yeah, we had a sandwich. He came back.
I know he did. Listen, why don't you put him back on the phone for me, all right?
Okay, it's me again.
Scott, this is very serious.
Look, I know. Honey, be careful with that.
Scott, do you have a gun?
No. And I would never do anything to hurt my daughter. I love her.
Of course you wouldn't. Listen to me, Scott. I need you to bring Hannah home. I need you to come back to the house. It's best for Hannah, and it's going to be best for you. I'll talk to the AUSA.
Okay, listen, what if we made a deal?
What kind of a deal?
Hey.
So you got her a job at the whorehouse?
Yes, Tiffany's got a job. She's not out on the streets. She works for Jada, your friend. Very upscale, very nice. You know, Tiffany could have a wonderful career.
Whores don't have careers, Jonah.
Well, Jada makes a good living.
Well, Jada's not a prostitute.
Anymore.
Were you planning on telling me this?
I wanted to talk to Jada. I wanted to make sure that Tiffany liked it, even. Today was her first day. The first day on any job can be very demanding.
And do you think she likes it?
I think she'll do well there.
She's my cousin.
She is an adult who, like me, recognizes a good business opportunity.
Oh, God, what am I going to say to Susan?
I don't think you have to say anything.
You just don't understand. This is my family. This is my family. You would not do this to your own flesh and blood.
I don't know that that's true. Look, the Supreme Court has ruled that a woman has the freedom and the right to do with her body as she wishes. Now, Tiffany is an intelligent woman who's made this decision on her own. No one has forced her.
What can I expect you to know about destroying a family? You don't care about my family. You don't even want a family.
Well, now you're so upset, you're saying things that you don't mean. I have never said I didn't want a child.
Yes, you do, Jonah. That's what you say all the time.
No, no, we have talked about it. I've never said no. Look at me. I haven't felt like this since my mother passed. And now I'm... Janet, there isn't a day that goes by without my thinking about the family we can have.
Really?
We'll talk about this later when you're less angry. I'm sorry about Tiffany. I really thought that I was doing...
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. You're right. She's a grown woman and she can make her own decisions. However misguided. Do I want to talk about us having a baby?
Okay.
Really?
Yeah, okay.
Samson.
Yes, ma'am.
Make sure the airspace is cleared and media moves down the street.
Take care of Boston.
Thank you.
You
guys, Ben Doran. Have you been Kelly up to date?
Yes, ma'am, I did.
So that's good news, huh? That's great news, actually. You know, I talked to Hannah myself.
You did?
Yes, I did. She sounds good. And we did promise Scott 5 minutes alone with you when he comes here. He wants to explain things.
Explain things?
You don't have to do this if you don't want to.
No, I want to. I do.
Okay. Everything else good?
Kill him for putting me through this.
Yeah, I know how you feel. But like I said, it's really good news.
Thank you.
Okay, I'll see you up front.
Bye.
It is really good news. You know that, right?
Mm-hmm.
You nervous?
No, Paige, can I just go to my bedroom and...
Yeah.
Change my clothes and freshen up? It's just... been quite a day.
Of course. Whatever you need, take your time.
Thanks.
Hey, there you are.
Oh, hey, Jade.
Hey, Danielle said you were looking for me.
Yeah.
How you doing?
Good. How you doing?
Good. So, what's up?
Jay, he's just about as sorry as he can be. We stayed up talking all night long.
Yeah, he snores pretty loud, doesn't he?
Yeah.
You know what this is between us, Roy?
He's about to drive me out of my friggin' mind.
Welcome to my world, now you see. So I just, I don't want to talk about it, okay?
All right. Guess I ain't no Kissinger, huh?
All right.
Oh, Roy.
Yep.
You got any booze in the house?
Beer, some whiskey, what?
You need to get rid of it. Okay?
Yeah, all right.
No, I mean, really, for me.
Okay.
All right, I'll see you later.
Yeah, sure.
Great. Thanks. Are you ready? He's minutes away.
Yeah.
Do I look okay? You look great.
Keep your hands on the steering wheel. I want you to take your right hand, put the car in park, turn off the ignition, and throw the keys out the window.
Okay. Throw these up here, Kenny. Okay, here's the keys.
Scott, I'm Lisa Cohen from the FBI. We're going to get Hannah out of the car first. You understand? Agent Sams is going to do that.
Hi, Hannah.
Honey, I love you.
It's Jennifer.
Scott, listen to me carefully. Hannah. Listen to me, Scott. Agent Stevens is going to get you out of the car. Do exactly what he says. Understand?
So give me a hand.
Give me your left hand. Step out of the vehicle.
Hannah.
In your right hand. Put your hands together, thumbs up. Put your chin in your chest. Spread your legs with your toes out.
Hey, Cal.
You got any weapons on you I need to know about?
This is just a cell phone.
You ready?
Clear.
Come here. 5 minutes.
Change your hair, Gil. Looks real nice. Look, I know what I did was wrong. Really wrong. But it was a chance. See, I was coming down the staircase, and I stopped at the 32nd floor. And I stayed there until the building shook from Tower 2 collapsing. I walked outside like it wasn't real. And there was dust everywhere and smoke and people screaming. And in that moment, I realized that I could...
What?
I could start over. Be happy again. Maybe. I can tell you, you and me, we weren't working. Job wasn't working. Nothing in my life was working. You know that. But I miss Hannah. I love you guys. That's why I came.
Medical attention on site immediately. Calm down.
Scott!
Stop!
Stop!
How you doing, Van Doren?
I'm okay.
Gun was in a lockbox in her closet.
What happens to Hannah?
Her grandmother will take care of her.
She had a second chance.
Yeah. I'll be in the car when you're ready, okay?
like them?
They're beautiful. But it still doesn't change what you said to me.
Well, Jada, when I lose my temper, I don't always mean what comes out of my mouth.
Yeah, I know you don't mean it, Donnie, and that's the problem. See, you don't seem to understand what it means for a black woman to hear that word come from her husband, who's supposed to love and respect her.
Jada, can't I come home and we just work it out there?
No.
Hey, Dad. Yeah, it's a tough day today. I saw a guy get shot.
And we have Candy. This is Valentine. Pam. And meet Sophie. Is there anyone that you like?
That one.
Valentine. Good choice. Just, could I talk to him?
Timmy?
Yeah.
He's doing his homework now.
Cut me a break, would you?